Good morning, all. My job is sort of to look at the road we've been on recently, the road traveled, and for some reason I'm reminded this year of the yellow brick road in the Wizard of Oz. Picture us like Dorothy, the Tin Man, the Scarecrow, and the Lion, working our way through that yellow brick road, and consider the perils we have faced as they faced perils. With the Wicked Witch of the West, better known as House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, with her flying monkeys, like Eric Holder, the Attorney General, who as soon as he took in his new office, wanted to renew the assault weapons ban. Or among the flying monkey crew, Hillary Clinton, who as Secretary of State opened the door to a UN gun ban, at least the possibility of one. And of course, there's the usual suspects. People like Charles Schumer, I like to refer to him as Chucky Schumer, and then there's Frankie Lautenberg. They're sort of the East Coast soprano team.
Thank you. It's great to be back here again. I appreciate you all inviting me. I see Eugene may have an actually longer packet than I have, so I think I made a mistake and now I'm flicking enough graphs on. It's hard for me to talk anymore these days without showing some graphs, but I'll do my best I can with this. Today I mentioned the third edition of War Guns, Less Crimes Out. Lots changed in the last decade since the second edition has come out. Obviously, we had the debate over gun bans in cities like Chicago and Washington, D.C. We've had the assault weapons ban sunset in September 2004. 40 states now have right to carry laws. There's only two states, Illinois and Wisconsin, that completely banned people carrying concealed carry. And it's quite possible that after this election, at least one or two of those will change. In the last few years, we've gone from about 5 million people carrying concealed carry permits in 2007 to about 6.2 million people right now who have it. And there's widespread changes in many other types of gun control laws like Stand Your Ground and Castle Doctrine.